Stephanie Shade, Chief Astrologer for JanSpiller.com, with your monthly horoscope. And this one's for you, Gemini. We're coming into September 2021, and Mercury, your ruling planet, is going to be retrograde at the end of the month. So heads up on that. I'll go into that in the horoscope. However, I want you to know you can use September's astrology in ways that help you get organized and circle back to unfinished business and conversations. There's actually a lot of productive things you can do during Mercury retrograde. Now, this month's new moon is at 14 degrees of Virgo. It's on September the 6th. If you were born on or around June 5th of any year, or you have around 14 degrees of Gemini rising, you could find that external circumstances spur you into action at this new moon. The new moon is actually in a bit of a challenging position, but sometimes that's what's needed to light a fire and get something started. And really, this new moon date is so key for that, because the next day, September 7th, is when we enter the shadow phase of Mercury retrograde. So making the new moon intentions is especially important this month, and making sure that even if it's one little baby step, that something gets started towards one of your top priorities at this new moon. So all Geminis can use the power of this new moon to set intentions related to their living situation, relationship with family, sense of security, self-care. This new moon and the rest of the month is an excellent time for cleaning or organizing projects. So if that's been on the to-do list for a while, that's some good news. You'll probably be able to dig into some of that fairly successfully. Now, like I mentioned, we enter the shadow phase of our next Mercury retrograde cycle on the 7th, and the official retrograde dates are September 27th to October 18th. So this means after September 7th, the energy begins to slow as we head towards this upcoming Mercury retrograde, and it will be best to focus on anything already in progress. Now, when we enter the official Mercury retrograde cycle, it's not going to be great timing to sign a lease or real estate documents, in particular for Gemini people. If you find you must change residence during this time period, I would go above and beyond your due diligence and get extra inspections, double check everything, because there's more margin for error during Mercury retrograde. It's the planet of our mind, and it's your ruling planet. It can be easy to miss certain details or have miscommunications under this type of astrology. Now, your best bet is to wait, if you can, to make major home-related purchases until early November, once we're free completely from the influence of this Mercury retrograde cycle. So keep those guidelines in mind. I know sometimes you just have to live your life. You can't stop everything. But if you have a choice, why not work with the astrology? That's what I always say. Do it during the best possible timing that you can. If you have to, like I said, make a major change or decision during Mercury retrograde, just use extra checks and caution, more so than you would during normal times. Now, we've got Venus entering Scorpio on September the 10th, and it will remain in this sign until October the 6th. So this astrology is really going to help you to strengthen your working relationships as well as your mind-body connection. This is a nice placement. Venus rules the body as well as relationship, as well as money. Scorpio is the sign that has to do with psychology and really breaking things down, understanding what's been going on beneath the surface. The second part of the month is going to be great to renegotiate an existing working agreement, as well as work with others as a team on the job. You could be feeling extra focused about a wellness routine, especially if it's one that you already started. This Venus in Scorpio can give you that drive and determination needed to stick with something that maybe is a fairly new routine for you. Now we've got Mars finishing its journey through Virgo on September the 13th and moving into the harmonious sign of Libra on the 14th. That's quite a favorable position for Gemini people because Libra is a fellow air sign. And you can use the first few weeks of the month to organize yourself for a creative project that you can immerse yourself in later in the fall. That's while Mars is in Virgo. After the 14th, when Mars moves into Libra, romance could definitely be afoot. Enjoy the moment if you're meeting someone new, but remember that new committed partnerships will not be supported at this time. So if you're single, you meet someone new, you're going to feel more clear about what you want after Mercury stations direct next month. But you can certainly live in the moment, see how it goes for now without making big relationship decisions or commitments. Now this month's full moon is going to be September 20th at 28 degrees of Pisces. It's going to shine a spotlight on your career and public image. If you were born on or around June 20th of any year, or if you have around 28 degrees of Gemini rising, you're gonna feel the strongest energy from this full moon. Now, all Gemini people might be feeling quite tuned in to their intuition around this time, especially regarding work. So if you have this feeling that maybe you should look into something or talk to a coworker about something, or that a hunch that a certain course of action could pay off, I would certainly investigate that around the full moon. And you're actually primed to receive some recognition for a job well done under this full moon. Now, September 22nd, the sun moves into Libra, and this date marks the fall equinox in the northern hemisphere and the spring equinox in the southern hemisphere. But all over the world, for Western astrology, which is what we're doing here, is the initiation of Libra season at this equinox. So this really will help Gemini sun and rising people nurture and cultivate romantic relationships in particular. If you are a parent and you work with children, you might also find that this is a really nice time to do a reset and balance your relationships in a more harmonious way. When I think of the equinoxes, and especially during a Mercury retrograde, I think, ooh, how can people push the reset button, rebalance anything that has just not felt like it's been harmonious in your life? Libra is going to help you bring in that harmony. So I hope you can make the most of September's astrology. Be safe and be well, and I will see you here next month with your horoscope.